Assalamu alaikum and good morning everybody. Today we are going to do example 4.7, which is basically a continuation from the previous example 4.6. So it is good for you to revise a little bit on example 4.6 in order to fully understand example 4.7. Alright, the question is shown here, which uses the machines from example 4.2, and if you recall it, that machine has a power rating of 12 kilowatt with a voltage of 100 volts and the armature current rating of 120 ampere. The magnetization curve for that machine at 1000 rpm is shown here, and under no load the machine draws, or the motor draws, 6 ampere of current, which is used to overcome the rotational losses. And at full load, the machine runs at 932 rpm, in which it draws 120 ampere of current. And this is done in example 4.6, and the motor is operated as a shunt motor. So if you recall, in example 4.6, the armature reaction is given in terms of the reductions in the flux per pole. Without the armature reaction, at full load, the machine runs at 885. And with the armature reactions, we have calculated that with the 5% reductions in the flux per pole, the machine speed increases to 932 rpm. Now, in this question, what we need to do is to find the equivalent ampere turns due to that armature reactions. Because in the previous question 4.6, or in the previous example 4.6, the armature reaction is given in terms of the reductions in the flux per pole. Here we want to find the armature reactions in terms of the field current reduction. Okay, so first I'm going to draw the shunt motor connection. Okay, so this is the schematic of a shunt motor. The terminal voltage is fixed at 100 volts, which is given in example 4.6. Therefore, the voltage across the field circuit is going to be at 100 volt as well. So if RFC does not change, then the field current is also not going to change, which means that if you write down the back EMF voltage, okay, that flux per pole will not change even when we load the motor. Okay, when we load the motor, then IA is going to change, is going to increase. That will increase that voltage drop across the armature resistance, which means that EA is going to change according to the equations EA equals to VT minus IA RA, which is a KVL around this loop. Okay, so as IA changes, that voltage drop changes. Since VT fixed, then EA is going to change. However, the flux per pole will not change, which means that when EA changes due to the changes in IA, then the speed will change. Okay, so this is opposite to what we have in the DC generator, where the speed is assumed to be constant, which is in which the generator is run by the prime mover, and the terminal voltage changes. Here, the terminal voltage is fixed, and the speed changes. Okay, so let's do the question A. Before we do that, I will show you I would like to show you the magnetization curve under these different conditions. The only curve that we have is the magnetization curve at 1000 RPM, which is as shown here. Okay, so at 1000 RPM is roughly given by this curve here. Let me just draw the sketch of the curve. This is a 1000 RPM, which is under no load conditions. When we did example 4.6 without the armature reactions, we found out that the speed is at 885. So 885 is somewhere there RPM, and under the armature reactions, also under full load, the speed increases to 932, which is given in this example as well as in some example 4.6. Alright, so under the no load condition, the back MF voltage, as we have calculated in example 4.6, is 99.4, which is probably somewhere here. Let's assume that it is somewhere here. So, and we have also found out that at 99.4, the field current is equals to 0.975 ampere. Okay, this is under the no load condition. When the machine is running in full load, then the speed reduces to 885, which means that it is under the same field current, so the operating point is there, and the terminal voltage according to VT minus IA times RA is equals to 88 volt, which is probably somewhere here. Let's assume that it is somewhere here. Okay, so that is without the armature reaction. Okay, when we include the armature reactions in example 4.6, it is equivalent to the reductions in the flux per pole of 5%, and the speed increases to 932. Since the loading is full load, and then the armature current is still the same at 120 ampere, therefore the back MF voltage EA is still at 88 volts. Okay, so due to that armature reaction, there is a reductions in the field flux, or reductions and equivalent reductions in the field current, which is given by that amount or magnitude. This is what we want to find in example 4.7. However, the problem is that we only have a curve at 1000 RPM. So, in order to find that current here, okay, we have to use the 1000 RPM curve, which means that under the same flux or field current, then if we can find this voltage, okay, then we can find that current. And how to find that voltage? Well, this is where we use the ratio. Okay, we know that the ratio of the voltage, back MF voltage, with 88 volts under the same field flux is equals to K phi at 1000 times 2 pi over 60 over K phi, the same flux per pole, at 932 times 2 pi over 60. Okay, so that 2 pi over 60 cancel out, and that K phi cancel out, so this just equals to 1000 over 932, which means that the back MF prime is equals to 1000 over 932 times 88, and that turns out to be 94.4 volts, which means that that voltage now is basically 94.4. That is basically equals to 94.4. So then, in order to find that field current, because we want to calculate that reductions in the field current, then we use the curve at 1000 RPM. So go back to the curve here, look for 94.4. There, the field current is can be obtained by projecting that down. That turns out to be 0.825. Okay, so which means that the reductions, the equivalent field current reductions due to the armature reactions, is equal to 0.975 minus 0.825, which is equals to 0.15 ampere. So the ampere turns equivalent NF times IF armature reaction is equal to the number of turns of the field winding, which is given in the example 4.2, is equals to 1200, 0.15. So that is equals to 180 ampere turns. Okay. The second question, part B, asks you how many series field turns per pole should be added to make this machine into a cumulative compound motor, which is short shunt, whose speed will be at 800 RPM at full load. So neglect the resistance of the series field winding. So it is still under the full load condition, which means that the EA is still equals to 88 volts. However, the speed now reduces to 800 RPM. So if I draw an equivalent, let's draw that in a different color here. At 800 is probably somewhere here. Okay, so that is at 800 RPM. Still at 88 volts, so the voltage is going to be, is the operating point is going to be there, which means that now we need to find what is the increment in the field current from here to here, which is needed by using the series winding, okay, or the cumulative compound. So what we need to do is, what is going to be that increment in the field current needed, which is going to be added by using that series winding. So again, we don't have the curve at 800, we only have the curve at 1000. So we have to find the voltage at the same field current in order to find the requirement or of the field current needed. So let's call that EA double prime. So we need to find that. Again, we are going to use the ratio in order to calculate that field current. So part B now, again using the ratio, EA double prime over 88 must be equals to K5 at 1000 over K5 at 800. I'm not going to multiply that with 2 pi over 60 because that will cancel out. Even K5 here is going to be cancelled out, which means that this just equals to 1000 over 800, which means that the back MF double prime is equal to 110 volts. Okay, so that is basically equals to 110 volts. So we're going to use the magnetization curve at 1000 to find what is the required field current here. So I'm going to draw a line here again at 110, which is here, and the field current is exactly at, if you draw a line going down here, then that is going to be at 1.4. So the required field current is equal to 1.4 ampere, which means that now I can write down the equations that we have used before in the compound generator. IF effective values, which is equals at 1.4, must be equals to IF actual plus the NS series over NF times IA plus IF minus IF armature reaction. So IF effective is 1.4 ampere and IF actual is 0.975 plus NS over 1200 times 120.975, okay, minus the one that we've just calculated, which is 0.15. So from here, NSR is basically equals to 5.7, which is roughly 6 turns. Okay, the last part of the question asks you to find the speed of the motor if the connection is a differential compound instead of the cumulative compound as we have done in part B. This is straightforward because we can use the same field current that we have, the current that we have calculated, but instead of using that plus here for the differential compound, then that is going to be equals to minus. Okay, and what we need to do is we need to find the effective field current now because we want to find the speed of the motor. We will solve for the field IF effective, and the actual is 90. So this is part C. So that turns out to be 0.22 ampere. So what is the speed then? Okay, the speed, which means that we have to go back to the curve here. I'm going to search for 0.22 view current, which is going to be somewhere here. Okay, so I'm going to draw a line from 0.22, which is probably going to be somewhere there. Okay, and what is the voltage? The back EMF voltage is 36. So that is 36 volts. So what is the speed then? So the speed is obviously, because the voltage is still at 88 volts under full load, then the new field current is at 0.22, which is somewhere here. Okay, probably somewhere here. Let's assume that is somewhere here, 0.22. Then the curve of the new speed is going to be, must be higher than that 1000 RPM. Okay, how do we find the speed? Again, we're going to take the ratio at 1000 RPM. Okay, we know that at 1000 RPM, the voltage is 36. Okay, so we know the voltage is 36 at 1000. What is going to be the speed here? Okay, so we take the ratio. Let me just write it down first. From the graph, EA is equal to 36 volts at 1000 RPM. Therefore, I can say that N, the speed that we want to find, over 1000 must be equals to 88, that is the EA at N RPM, over 36, which is the back EMF at 1000 RPM. And N turns out to be 2444 RPM. So the speed there is going to be at 2444 RPM. So that finishes example 4.7.